Okay, in this video, we're gonna use paint.net to clean photos. So it'll be editing an image to remove the background and sort of some of the techniques to smudge the pictures. This is an alternative if you don't have Photoshop. Paint.net is free to download, so go ahead and download that. Once you have this app, then we can begin. So first and foremost, find the image that you want. So in this case, it's this for me. What I want to do is I want to remove the external image here around my target component. So a good practice whenever you edit an image is to always make a copy of the prime image. So here you can Control A, Control C, Control Shift V. That copies it as a new layer. Or alternatively, Control A, Control C to select this whole thing, add a new layer, and then Control V. So I'll delete that. And then what we'll do is we'll tick that to hide the background. We'll work only on this image. And what we want to do, first and foremost, is get this lasso tool or the S key. And again, there's a few ways of grabbing it, and it depends on the complexity of the image. So sometimes you might want to go inside and remove externally, and sometimes you want to go outside. In this case, I think it's easier to get the image outside. So control scroll will zoom in and out like that. Shift scroll will go left and right like that. And alt, that just changes the selection. So we're in lasso mode, lasso, whatever. Press control, you can see the icon changes to a plus there. As you hold control, that adds a selection. So like this. That's in our selection now. And then what I tend to do is I go around making a big D around straight lines. So I know I want to go up to there, roughly speaking. And having a mouse or a trackpad that you can control will obviously improve this. But nonetheless, this will work just the same. We now need to build into that. Go around the component, into it like that. So that's a selection made. I'm holding control the whole time. Or alternatively, what you can do is just select this guy, add. And what that does is that everything you do now is a union or in addition to your selection, automatically saves you holding control. So these details sometimes can be easier to remove by deselecting a range. So I've overshot there, that component needs to go away. I'll press alternate or the alt key or select this guy, subtract, and I'll go around like that. And that will remove that bit of selection. And there are ways to get oval elements using ellipses. But I think in this instance, let's just go around the component. So if it's a simple image, then going around doing this might work. But if you want to speed up the process, then what you can do is you can add another layer above, Control N. We can deselect all of this, just go into there, press Escape. So I've got a hidden background layer, just in case I mess up this image. I've always got this to go back to. And then I've added a layer above. And what you can do is you can press this setting properties or F4 and name it. We'll call this the sketch. And then what we'll do, we will draw some lines. We will draw them in black lines. So here I'm just gonna basically trace the component, and hopefully it creates a nice continuous line, which we can see later. Doesn't have to be perfect, just make sure it's closed. So drawing a line can be easier. I'm drawing a line, pressing escape, because otherwise I will be selecting the nodes to adjust the line like that, which is handy for curves. I'm scrolling, shift scroll to go around. Then I've got this pipe here, which is a bend. So I'll go up to that corner. I'll just add selection there. Just about so, that looks right. Control scroll to zoom. Go again up to there. We'll just take the external to start with. The other thing, if you don't want to press escape every line, you can draw backwards. So instead of drawing this way, I'm going to draw this way to connect the node. This ensures that basically I'm still making my selection. I'm just not having to press escape. I'm always drawing backwards like that. Oh, I've taken too much here. But that's okay. So we don't want that image there. That background is a trolley. Just want these guys here. That doesn't matter if it overshoots, because what we want is the innards. Take that little corner. Obviously this can be tedious, because you want to select a whole range of image, which when the color is very contrasting is very easy to do. But when it's not, and there's similarity, and for greater control, this kind of gives you the best option. Let's say I know I'm going to go in this edit mode. What I'm going to do is press F5, F6, F7, F8. That removes the template. It gives me a bit more space to work with. So we'll go around all of these guys here. Keep going. And you don't want to take too complex of a shape, because obviously you can control only 4 nodes in your illustration here. I just zoom out to check. Yep. So one curve is normally good. More than that, it's a little bit tricky. Go in there, there. Might not be the best way to do this. But it is workable. Like that, the curve is too much for us. And I have to go trace it back. And and how far are we? About 50% through this. Makes it look kind of cool as well, to be honest. Go there. Here. There is a tricky element at the end if you're doing it this way, which is you have to make sure the whole thing is closed. I want to drag it this way. In fact, it doesn't matter that I've missed that. I will add that. So we'll see in a minute why that is useful. Doot. It's kind of therapeutic, to be honest. So I am pressing escape now, because it just seems simple. Scroll to the right. Almost there. Get that over here.
Safmi said.
Oh, we've got an interjection. What did he say? Goodbye. Cool. And then we go from here to here.
Safmi said.
From here to here. And maybe close that loop a little bit. Don't want to bite too much. Like a tiny curve. The simpler the curve, the easier it is. That. And then we'll time ourselves when we go the other way. That. Move those around. Like so. Going up. Little curve here. Keep going. Half curve. The reason I don't take the full curve is it doesn't often suit it perfectly. In this instance, that's okay. But half a circle is good. Get that. Get that. Get that. That. The other thing that's nice is if you change the thickness. The thicker the line here is 2, the easier it is to sort of draw within the lines. And we'll learn how to smudge later for, let's say, if you had a finger in this handle and you wanted to get rid of that finger, we can use the smudge tool, which is a plugin you'll have to download. And the other thing you could do, if it's a lot of black, can enable the palette again, make the lines red, make it easier to see. It doesn't have to be the same color, because when we look at the drawing in a bit, all we care about is that it closes that loop. Here we go. That half circle, so that's okay. Draw through there. Bit edgy. So if this was a thinner line, it's very hard to control. And if it was thicker line, it's easier to control, but it might overshoot what you're aiming for. So the width 2 is kind of perfect for this job. So almost there, I think. We want to include that. And then we'll check the other method to see if it's quicker. Almost. And the more complex the image, the more time you'll have to spend to do this. But that's okay. quality over quantity. A good image carries a lot of weight, especially in a manufacturing environment, because you don't want that to be seen in your procedures. You want it to look professional. That's it, I think. And then what we can do is close the image to see if we have a full layer. Yep. All these lines are closed. Seemingly. What I can do is now go to select. Instead of lasso, I want the magic wand. That guy. And I'll select all of it in here. And then what I want to do is, instead of have it on the sketch layer, I'll select the image. Let's name this image for prosperity. And then what we can do is, it doesn't matter if you're looking at the image or not. With the image selected, the layer selected, I can press Control Shift X. And what that does is it just removes the bits outside. Instantly we've got what we want, basically very close to, very clean, nearly perfect. Now we just have to chuck the insides here. So using the lasso this time, I'm gonna make those changes. The lasso not so good for corners. And add all of those. Add those. So, as we're adding this corner here, if it's a straight line, it's slightly easier. But because this is a corner like that, you're going to struggle to use just a lasso. So, again, we can go to that sketch. We don't have to look at it. We can go O for the line, and you can draw curved lines, you can draw straight lines depending on the node. And I want to show my sketch. Actually, I don't want to draw on the image, I want to draw on the sketch. And just like that. And that gives me my curve. Very nearly accurate. Another curve here. And the lines don't have to be perfect, because we can draw. When we go to select it, we'll go to the image again. Go to the magic wand. Select it. We've missed something. Hide the image. It will explain why we've missed. Oh, sorry. We want to select on the sketch. That way we'll select a perfect selection like that. And then we go on to the image like that. Press delete. And that's gone. Another thing here, I can see a little curve here, but it's tiny. So this one would be easier to use the lasso for. Lasso, lasso. I keep swapping between those two. Whatever, man. Whatever makes you happy. So we do D's, a bunch of D's for straight lines like that. And then we get in this corner. And it's better to drag down for corners like that. And better to push up for lines, for straight lines. That's just a normal alt to remove some of those sections. And then delete, that's gone. And that's it, we've got a very nice image that's been cleaned. Let's say your image, you want to hide these screws, for example. What we can do with the image selected, we can go to effects, render, photo, where is it? Oh, I think I haven't got the add-on here. called Smudge. Let me look that up now. Smudge plugin. Paint.net. Okay, so go to Google, get to your, just look up Smudge plugin, Smudge or smear tool. Any one of these will work. If this is your own image, if this is your own PC, obviously you can do this. But if it's not, you will have to ask your admin to install it. So we'll go to the plugin. You can download the zip or just install it direct. I'm gonna try to install it direct. Run it. Sorry, that's what you get once you extract the files. Install for me. Agree. Sure. Finish. Done. We will have to save this, I think. This file. Save. It will ask you to save in PDN, which is going to be in these layers. Paint.net native file. But if you want, which I'll do for now, just so that we can open it in a bit. Okay, so we've got that. Don't know if it's, I don't think it's ready. Don't save. Right. Let's look it up. Sample PDN. Open that. That's our image. Effects, tools, smudge. That's the kitty. So now we want to get rid of these screws. Click the smudge tool in under tools. Go to your image. And then you have a brush size here. You can change that brush size. Make it bigger. You can select the number here and scroll up and down. So that's bigger. I think 30 was, or 35 was just fine. And then zoom into what you want. And then just smudge the image like that. It's like using a paintbrush, basically. All you're doing is just smudging that to make it look as if it's one continuous thing. So now it looks like a continuous component. You can do this with hands, gloves, whatever. Just smudge the layer over that you would like. So if I had something here that is over the yellow, the jig, I can smudge. Imagine it's a paintbrush. Drag the yellow over the fingers or whatever effect. So let's say I wanted to get rid of these little studs here. I can take the yellow here and just run over it. If I take from this side, I'm smudging the other way. I'm taking the color that I don't want into the color that I want. Take the color you want and just smudge it into the color you do not want. And there is a manual way of doing this if you couldn't get smudge tool, which is basically copying a small square section and then pasting as above that image many, many times. But I'd rather not show you that because it's absolutely barbaric. So yeah, that image. Obviously, you can undo this with Control Z, etc. But in this instance, it does seem like we've smudged this okay. Not perfect, but okay. It's like painting. It's like a work of art. There you go. Two bits smudged. Press OK. And then it's updated our image to reflect that. I think we did it on the background, actually. So if we close that, it's done it on this. So we need to select the image we want, like that. Effects, tools, smudge.
Saf me said.
Oh dear. And then we go in and smudge like we did before. I won't do the studs, I'll just do the
Saf me said.
Screws. Smudge, smudge, smudge. Done. Okay. There you go. that's modified the image. That screw's completely gone. And now we're just left with a clean plate using the smudge factor, the smudge tool. You have a bunch of other effects, but really smudge is all I've ever used. And once you're done, if you wanted to paste this into Word, let's say, then what you do is press Control Shift F. That will flatten your image, or select the top layer here. And then you can say merge layer down like this. Yeah, but you don't want to. So the only image we want is this one. It depends on what you've done with your image. If I had multiple layers above this, let's say I drew a square box. Ooh. Well, that's not a square box. Let's say I drew something on top like that. That's an example. And I wanted to keep that layer. Then I'd merge it down. And then it becomes one complete layer like that. Merge layer down. So this, if I deleted this now, and the background as well, then that image is part of this now. I've basically painted or drawn on the image here, which I don't want to do. So I want to delete layer 4, which is what I started with. I can even undo. The sketch we did, we don't actually want. So we can, I think, press Control Shift F, and that does it properly. And if we merge it down, yeah, I think I press Move Layer Down, which isn't what you want. You want Merge Layer Down. And the reason this has gone missing, if I'm honest, I don't know. Why did it disappear? Merge down. This layer, oh, I see. So this, in this layer, this area is transparent. So any image below it will show the background. So again, Control Shift F is the best option. It will give you what you see. Another option instead of Control Shift F is just press flatten. That's it. And that's your image now. You can press Control AC and then paste this as an image in your Word file or Excel or wherever you want to paste this. And if you save this now, you can save this as a PNG, JPEG file, whatever. And if you wanted to keep the PDN file for future edits, let's say I wanted to make, in the future, let's say I wanted, oh, because the background's disappeared on this one. We didn't actually make the changes to the background. I think that was an error on my part. But let's say you wanted to make an update, you wanted to undo the smudge or something like that, then you would still have this layer. Had we not actually smudged this layer, and we can make more edits to the original file. So we can save that as a PDN, open it, and revert changes as we see fit. I'd close this now, save, and open it again. Yeah, if you save, close, and open again, the history is lost. But the layers are saved. My sketch is still there. Apparently that's the only sketch, which means I must have flattened that into here. That's fine. So yeah, that's it. One other thing, I don't know if I covered this. Obviously you've got a palette here. You can use the fill color code areas, let's say, change the background. Instead of this single fill, you can use global fill, we call it. And as you press that, it will fill every color that matches that color. In this case, it's a transparent background. So every transparent background now becomes red. And you have primary colors. If I press right click, it becomes a secondary color. Sometimes, if you save this as a PNG, the background, if it's in transparent layer, will sit over a text in Word. The easiest way is just fill it with white, so it will prevent, it will see this as a square image versus an image that sort of is skirting around the outline. And that's it. That's how you edit the image as easily as I can think of using paint.net. Good luck.